Now, I'm sitting here, I'm trying to watch my ratchet television. This is at the time when I used to watch Love & Hip Hop or whatever. I'm sitting here chilling. All of a sudden, the girl comes in. I look. I'm like, oh, okay, her again. Go back to my television. I'm trying to watch my Love & Hip Hop. Michelle starts wilding. Because I guess Michelle was already in the room. And she comes out, and now she's kind of talking as if Rachel isn't there.
Story!
Girl, now they start. This is like a screaming match, like a screaming match that I've never seen. I kid you not, I felt like I was on oxygen. I felt like I was on Bad Girls Club. So as you guys can imagine, my boyfriend's fucking deployed, my best friend's smoking and drinking while she's pregnant, my roommates are fucking batshit crazy, I'm living with a stinky bitch that don't like to clean the microwave, I'm living with another bitch that don't like to clean the stove or clean her dishes, bitches is always fighting over shit that don't even make sense. I was extremely stressed and annoyed. I believe I failed a class that year as well. Like, shit was just fucking annoying. The Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And yes, different scenery. We are live from my master bedroom. I know you guys are probably like, what the fuck? Where is the house tour? I know. Eventually. I just gotta think of something more creative, okay? Last house tour was pretty nice. It was pretty fun. I like the way I did it. Now I need to think of a new one. So relax. It's coming. As you can see by the title, we are going to be doing a Storytime movie. Now, I haven't done one of these in... it has to be over a year. For the simple fact that a lot of my Storytime movies literally take a lot of work, a lot of memory, and it kind of like brings a lot out of me. Also because some people are always upset every fucking time I do one of these. But it's come to the point where it's like, I don't give a fuck. Like, a lot of this shit happened years ago. If you still mad, whatever. The only reason I make these videos is to kind of help you guys who may be going through similar situations, as well as just literally expressing how I feel, because this is very, very therapeutic. Like, I usually talk about this stuff in therapy, but it's something different when you have no one around you, and you could just go off and talk to yourself on the camera, but then there's other people there, but they not, but they are. You get the point. So get your tea, get your snacks. Get everything, because this story is going to be a pretty long one. So as the year is ending, I wanted to make sure I got all of this shit off of my chest, because we not bringing none of this shit into 2021. And quite frankly, I kind of want everything to be squashed at this point. But yeah, I mean, if anyone feels some type of way, I mean, I said what I said, and everyone that I'm mentioning in this video knows how I feel about them already at this point. And knows whatever they did or did not do is something I definitely frowned upon. So yeah, ain't nobody talking behind nobody back. This is the internet. Oh well, if you have a problem with what I said, oh well. Before we get started, as you guys watch this video, I know you guys got a lot to say. So comment down below, what are your roommate horror stories? Or if you do not have one, just make sure you comment down below, what is your worst experience in general in terms of dealing with friends, okay? Because I would love to hear your stories down below. Please make sure you check the description box, because there is so much going on in terms of what I'm doing in life right now, such as my podcast, my second channel, merchandise, one-on-one social media consultations. Everything is down there, as well as my skin routine, because I know a lot of people like to ask. So we're going to be talking about my roommates from... hell. Honestly, I'm gonna have to let you know the lesson before we even get through the end of this, because a lot of you guys may not make it through the end of this. The lesson is, don't live with your friends. If you love your friends, if you care for your friends, if you care for the friendship, do not live with them. This entire situation fucked up all of our friendships to the point where all of us are not really where we used to be. So let's just start it off. I went to Bloomfield College in Bloomfield, New Jersey. I started in 2013, ended in 2017. Now, contrary to most people here on YouTube, I've had amazing roommate situation. This is a sweet mate story, okay? This is my sweet mates from hell, realistically, because my roommates were perfectly fine to me. But with all of the shit that went down, child, do not live with your friends. So we have to give a quick preface of what happened before it happened. Now, Bloomfield College used to have a contract with Rutgers in Newark, New Jersey to use their university center. So there was a shuttle that used to bring us back and forth from Bloomfield College's campus to Rutgers campus. When I'm telling you guys, this shit was elite. It was amazing because a lot of commuters were able to take this instead of taking the bus. Or like, you know, it saved us money. It was good for the parties. We got to go to fraternity row and stuff like that. It was great. The main reason Bloomfield did that is because they didn't really have enough places to house their students. So eventually they did cultivate a whole brand new building, and this was called the Franklin Dorm, okay? Now, I ain't gonna lie. Franklin Dorm was nice. It was like the university center on steroids at first. But let me just say, especially if any Bloomfield heads is watching this shit right now, like, especially like, anybody that's in charge of making decisions. Franklin was just built and it always had fucking problems, okay? From leaks to pipes to all types of problems, and it makes no sense. It's like they did a really, really rushed job because the contract was ending and they didn't want to renew the contract with the UC as well as with the shuttle service. So it was a really, really rushed job. And aside from that being a problem, every single suite in this building housed 8 students. You guys are probably like, excuse me? Yes. 8 students, 2 per room, 4 rooms, 8 fucking students. I kid you not, as soon as I heard this, I said, what the fuck? Like, that is way too many people in a dorm. But it was the newest, it was the nicest. And plus, I don't know how many other schools do it, but the way Bloomfield does it, every grade is usually typically sent to specific things. Seniors usually have houses, juniors usually have Franklin. Freshmen usually have CLE or Schweitzer. Like, different halls are designated to different grades, and usually you don't have a choice in terms of where you want to live unless you come extremely early or extremely late, or you just know somebody that give you the plug. Sometimes you get lucky, but most of the time you are where you are. My logic was, okay, if I'm gonna have to fucking live in this building, which is literally gonna be Bad Girls Club 2.0, because that's really what it is. When you really think about it, 8 bitches in a dorm is literally Bad Girls Club reality. Why the hell would you have that many people in a dorm? Like, it's a horrible idea. I feel like they really, really rushed this bunch of motherfuckers. One suite, they want to make as much money as possible. So, essentially, I was like, you know what? If I'm going to be forced to live in this dorm, which I really didn't want to, most of my friends didn't really want to either. We either wanted to live in a house or stay in 225, because 225 was a sophomore dorm and many of us was coming from there. But we were forced to go there. So, we was like, you know what? Let's all live together. This was initially my idea. And honestly, this is all my fucking fault, because I should have thought this through. I should have listened to what people told me my entire life, which is do not live with your friends. So we go to housing selection day. I believe housing selection day was like a set time. Usually we had to skip a class or two to fucking get there. It was long ass lines, a paper process. I really hate the housing process, to be honest, at Bloomfield. I would hope they did a better job at making it better. I would hope they like actually started making it online or something, but who knows. And basically I remember us having about like 6 people, I believe, and then we added 2 people to the cut because we was like, you know what, we need 8 and we don't want no randoms getting thrown into our dorm. Like, all have the same agreement of we do not need no randoms being thrown in our dorm, because we all know randoms cause problems. But at this point, everybody causes problems. So essentially we added 2 people that we knew, but like they weren't like part of the squad or whatever, but we knew them. So in college I had a squad. If you guys watched one of my vlogs recently, you would have saw I got all of my squad together. There was a couple of people missing, but for the most part that was the squad. But a lot of you pointed out like, damn, you have a lot of guy friends, you have a lot of guy friends. Oh no, there was bitches in the equation. Some of them didn't come that day, but they were invited. But some of them just weren't invited because of the situation that happened in the dorms and just other situations external to that. But I just have to let you guys know that literally all of us were friends. We used to hang out together, we would turn up together. Like, we were the squad. Like, niggas used to want to be part of the squad. Like, we were squad. Like, literally we called each other squad. We'd be like, what up squad? Like, We was really, really close. We went from being stalked together, which I have a story to talk about that. I'm going to have to redo that one. Yes, we've gotten stalked together. We've had lots of situations together. Like, we were really, really tight-knit as a group of friends. And there had to be a good, like, let me see. If I'm counting the boys alone, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I would say it's like 5 boys and about 5 to 6 girls. So all together, it's like 12 squad. And I used to call them squad extended, which was people that we were still cool with. They weren't like necessarily squad, but they would be around. Like, yo, listen, this was a whole thing. This is a whole thing. And we had 2 people that were kind of like squad extended, but they were like real, real cool. To them, I didn't like the one bitch. Now, this one bitch, we're going to call her Squeaky. Anyone that went to Google College with me would know who Squeaky is. I don't care for that bitch because she tried to make a video about me and my friends trying to say we was bullying her ass. But ain't nobody bully her dumb ass. My thing is, if you know I don't like you and you keep bothering me, whatever happens to you, happens to you. Because at that point, you're antagonizing me. No one bullied that girl. I told her straight up I ain't like her. She felt some type of way about it, but nonetheless, I'm gonna get to that later. So we had Squeaky, and there was another girl that was part of the that we added, that she wasn't really squad, but she was always with us, and we were extremely cool with her. And her name was Rachel. Now, Rachel happened to be a lesbian, and she was a stud, so keep that in mind because it is important to the story. So we go and we get the housing assignment. Everything is set. I had a roommate that I've always had for the entire college career up until junior year, and that was one of my friends. We're going to call her Michelle. Again, if anyone knows me, they know these people, but please do not comment nobody's name in the comment section because I ain't got time for that. But anyhow, me and Michelle have always roomed together from freshman year to sophomore year. Junior year, we were suite mates. We were not roommates. And the only reason we weren't roommates is because I decided to roommate with one of our friends named Danielle. Now, as much as we all get along together, we are all very, very particular. All of us were on this whole, I'll room with her, but I won't room with her. I'll room with her, but I won't. Like, it was just ridiculous. So the way we set it up, it was like, okay, well, Michelle will be directly right next to me, which is fine. And then I'll just be rooming with Danielle. Fuck it. So I'm rooming with Danielle. Michelle is rooming with Rachel. Now we have to give everybody else their names and whatever. So this is the original lineup. Me, Danielle, Michelle, Rachel, Ariel, Ashley, Jasmine, Squeaky. This is the original lineup. Now, let me just tell you, this was when I was in my previous relationship with a man who was in the military, and he ended up being deployed and didn't really tell me because he knew I would be really, really stressed and really, really depressed. And I honestly did tell him straight up, like, don't tell me because I really don't want to know because I'm going to be really, really stressed and really, really depressed. I don't do well with stress at all. Like, none of us do. But for me, it plagues me really badly. Like, literally, this year was so stressful knowing that he was deployed and didn't tell me because, like, I kind of figured it out. Honestly, he didn't really have to tell me. I kind of figured it out. And all of the shit that was going on, that I literally had a headache to the point where I couldn't walk. Like, every time I took a step, it felt like someone was banging me in my head. It was that bad. Like, I get really, really bad headaches. I gained an obscene amount of weight. Like, I do not do well with stress. So I was dating this dude or whatever. He helped me move in. Everything was great. Then I see Danielle's not here. We hitting up Danielle. We said, where you at? What you doing? She gonna say,
I'm not coming back this semester. I changed school.
Bitch, are you dumb? First of all, why the fuck did you tell us that you changed school? So at this point, we're like, oh my fucking God, we're gonna have a replacement. We're gonna have a replacement. And this is going to be horrible. Like, this is ridiculous. Now our shit is already infiltrated, okay? So now it's only 7 of us. We're gonna have a random, we don't know who this is. We were so fucking upset, but I was more upset because it's like, I'm gonna be rooming with some bitch I don't know. I've never roomed with anybody I didn't know throughout college ever. I've always been able to pick my roommate. I went with my roommate, okay, which was Michelle. And you guys would think, oh, why didn't you just go ask that Michelle be put in your room? Raw, bitch. They said, no, you can't have Michelle in your room. I said, the fuck? She's next door. She's next door. What do you mean? What do you mean? I can't. Ooh, child. I was so upset. So they didn't let Michelle room with me, which really annoyed me. So I ended up getting a new roommate. And her name was Malicia. Okay, that's what we're going to name her. And she happened to be someone that I knew. I knew her, like, we weren't close, but we were really, really cool. I was really cool friends with one of her friends, so I wasn't really too upset about this whatsoever. I actually really liked her. We got along very well. Like, shit was great for me. Until Malicia started fucking the game up, okay? So, here's instance number one. Malicia liked to cook, if that's what you called it. Malicia, I'm gonna just say this right now. For anybody that cooks rice out of a bag, that's disgusting. I'm just saying it's nasty. Like, I feel like if you want, like, a healthcare regimen, something like that, you're, like, you're trying to be healthy, whatever, maybe. But, like, for the motherfuckers out here cooking rice in a bag, like, I'm Haitian. So, it's like, anybody come quit Bag inside on no sachet, that's nasty, that's a problem. Like, why are you cooking rice in a bag? Like, that shit is unheard of to me. But she would cook, like, this rice in a bag, then she would cook her little, like, salmon with no seasoning. Wow, the shade, I'm sorry. She would cook a lot, okay? Let me just say, she would cook a lot. And she would have this habit of not cleaning her pot. I would cook sometimes, once in a blue moon. I didn't cook much because I was very busy. I was part of student government. I had Haitian Student Association. I had the boyfriend. I had a lot going on, so I didn't cook much. But I also would cook time and time again. But both of us were the ones that kind of cooked the most. So she would never clean her dish. But with all due respect, at one point I did have a pot that was lingering. But it was because, like, it was like rice, I think, and I had to scrub it, and I didn't have like a Brillo pad, and for whatever reason, all the stores near us were out of Brillo pads, didn't have a car, whatever. But like, I literally did my best to like keep it out of people's way or whatever. Like, I didn't like leave it in the sink. Like, I kind of just trump it. Like, I left water in it, soap in it, you know, and it was only there for a couple days. But she would consistently do this on a regular basis to the point where, like, we already had a squad group chat and they were talking like, bruh, like, shorty, you gotta tell your roommate, like, she need to clean her fucking dishes. Like, this shit is ridiculous. Like, it's stinking about the suite. We getting bugs. We getting flies. We getting roaches. Like, bitches is dirty. Da, da, da. Like, you know, just talking hella shit. So, just to, like, kind of, like, you know, calm things down, I hit her up, like, hey, Malisha, like, people are really complaining. They're really upset. Can you please clean your dish? You know, it's creating bugs and stuff like that. Ooh, child. She said,
if they got a problem with my dishes, they can fucking clean it themselves.
So me being me, I relayed the message. But yeah, I sent a screenshot. I said, screenshot. She said, y'all can clean it yourselves. They're upset. They're mad as fuck. Now, all of a sudden, we got hella tension in the motherfucking suite. This is when shit really, really, really got, like, unbelievably childish. At one point, we were sharing everything in the suite. We bought one milk, one bread, one this, one that. But now, everyone's buying their own bread, their own milk. So, we got, like, 6 milks in the fridge, 10 breads in the fridge. Like, it was just unnecessary. Everything was super fucking full. People were taking shit out of each other's cabinets because we all had designated cabinets, but no one was able to keep anything accounted for. No one was ever opening their mouths to say who took what and who put what where. People were holding their own trash bags, which was just so stupid. Like, why do we have our own trash bags? Like, can you imagine everyone buying their own trash bags and hiding it in their room? Niggas is just like eyeing each other, grilling each other. Now all of a sudden all this petty shit start happening. Nobody want to take out the trash. Nobody want to wipe the counter. Nobody want to clean the microwave. So now let's bring up the microwave situation. Now this is another reason I didn't like Squeaky. Now the thing is, I didn't like Squeaky from the rip, but I was able to be cordial with her. But after this situation, it was like, bitch, done with her. Like, I just really couldn't stand her. Okay, now Squeaky, she a preservative type of girl. Okay, she liked to eat all the garbage that none of us would dare touch unless we were poor. If you eat this shit and you have money, there's something wrong with you. Okay, I'm talking about Chef Boyardee, I'm talking about Kraft mac and cheese, all of that shit. Yeah, she's sitting there making that shit every single day. I've never seen her have a real meal. Now, the reason I'm throwing all this shade is because this bitch loved to talk about how much money she got, how many people that are higher up in the status of life, such as like officers or lawyers or whatever, people who even worked at the school that she was related to, and she got this money, she got that money. So it's like, why are you eating like us po folk? Okay, we all know Chef Boyardee, ramen, all of that. That's what college kids eat. But if you got so much money, right? If you big ballin', you been pippin', why you eating that shit then? You fucking rat. Oh my God, I did not like that girl. My thing is, if you're gonna cook, please cook real shit. But anyways, she would put this in the microwave or whatever, and you know, she wouldn't cover it. She wouldn't cover it. There was a microwave cover, but she wouldn't cover it. And it would fuck up the entire microwave. And she wouldn't clean it. She would just leave it. And she would do this continuously. So you can imagine how many roaches literally bought a mortgage at this suite at this point. We got a dirty microwave. We got dirty pots around the sink. The stove was dirty as well. Like, it was just nasty. Malisha didn't want to clean the stove. She didn't want to clean her pots. Then you have Squeaky, who didn't want to clean the microwave. She was just nasty. Okay, it was a hot, greasy mess. So, again, that became a problem. People started coming at her. But eventually, Squeaky did clean the microwave. But again, Malisha refused to clean the pot. So, it ended up being a whole situation where we had to have a house meeting.
I also forgot to mention, there were 8 people in the suite, but there were 2 bathrooms, 4 to each bathroom. C and D shared a bathroom. A and B shared the other bathroom. I was in D. And as you guys know, my friend that was also one of my roommates forever shared the bathroom with me, along with whoever our roommates were at the time, because there were a lot of switches. And we didn't really have too much issues with our bathroom, but A and B was always having problems with their bathroom. As far as like keeping it clean and stuff like that, every day there was a constant argument.
And you know, shit is discussed, whatever. I believe Malisha ended up either throwing away the pot or cleaning the pot, whatever. All was good, but nonetheless, she ended up leaving the first semester anyway, so whatever. So now I get a new roommate, which was very annoying, but we're gonna have to stop there for 2 seconds because we have to get back into Squeaky and why I don't really like her. So honestly, the funny thing is, I didn't like her before this due to other reasons that I'm not gonna say because privacy reasons, but it was just like, she's like trying to come into my room. She's trying to hop in my videos. She's trying to like, if I'm sitting at the counter, she's trying to ask me if she can ask him about my food. And it's like, I don't get it. Like, my thing is, I'm the type of person, when I don't like you, I kind of let it be known. Like, you kind of know why I don't like you, but the girl, I don't know. I don't know if she just wasn't getting it or what. Oh my God, it was annoying. It was like having a fucking like roach in your house and you're trying to get them like out of the house, but like they won't get out of the house. Literally the experience it felt like, okay? So it came to a point where I told like straight up, like, I don't like you. I don't know if y'all know if I don't like you, but I don't like you. And I would really appreciate if you stopped trying to interact with me because I genuinely don't like you. Like, we could be on some cordial shit or some high and bye, but I don't like you. And at this point, it's ridiculous. And you guys are probably like, what the fuck, like, you really said that here? Like, yes. Cause I'm not like a regular person, okay? Like, if I don't like you, I'm gonna tell you I don't like you. If I don't want you in my face, I'm gonna tell you I don't want you in my face. Because once that happens, then you're gonna be quick to say I'm just that and third. I'm gonna let you know straight up, I don't like you. Because at that point, I'm giving you signals, not getting it. So I told her straight up, I don't like you. Like, and I didn't do this in front of people. It's not like I embarrassed her or anything. Like, I literally took her aside. I took her to one of like little study rooms. I told her like, listen, like, I genuinely don't like you. I don't like the way you move. I don't like how fake you are. I heard you talking shit about us. Like, I don't like, I told her straight up. And now she making a scene out of this shit. She doesn't like me. I don't know what the fuck I did to her. This bitch is always acting up. She lucky I'm in college right now, because if we was in the hood, I would have rocked your shit. I would have rocked your shit, because who the fuck? Who the fuck? Why the fuck? How the fuck? Like, bitch, shut up. Who cares if I don't like you? Like, this whole emphasis that people have, and like whole pride that people have in people and how they feel about them is really, really toxic and really, really dangerous. Like, I don't like her. I told her I didn't like her and that was that. I wasn't trying to get anything out of it. I just wanted her to stop fucking communicating with me before I really, really, really hurt the girl's feelings. Now she wanna go around like, oh, shorty's this, shorty's a bitch, shorty's that. Bitch, I don't like you, that's it. Like, who cares? Like, why do you have to go around saying this, that, and that? Like, it's really unnecessary. So yeah, that's that on that. While that whole situation was happening, there was another situation brewing in the suite next to me with Rachel and my old roommate slash best friend, Michelle. Now, like I said, Rachel happened to be a lesbian and she got the bitches, all right, okay? Rachel was out here. She made that note. Very much so. She had one girl that was always coming to the suite to the point where I thought she was another suite mate. Like, bitch, she might as well have slept on the couch. Like, she was always there. And Michelle was very annoyed by this. And Michelle would always express this to me. She expressed it to Rachel. She expressed it to everybody in the suite. Like, yo,
she keep having this girl coming over here. Like, and my thing is, I don't have a problem with her coming here. My problem is she don't tell me. Like, she just shows up. And that's mad inconvenient. Like, she be sleeping over. She be making noise. She be this, she be that.
And I'm just like, I don't know. I'm not about to sit here and, like, go interfere. It's like, what you want me to say? I don't live with her. After months, and I tell you months, Michelle went crazy. One day, the girl came to the room as normal. Now, I'm sitting here. I'm trying to watch my Rachel television. This is at the time when I used to watch Love & Hip Hop or whatever. I'm sitting here chilling. All of a sudden, the girl comes in. I look. I'm like, oh, okay, her again. Go back to my television. I'm trying to watch my Love & Hip Hop. Michelle starts wilding. Because I guess Michelle was already in the room. And she comes out. And now she's kind of talking as if Rachel isn't there.
Sure.
Yeah, girl, that started a problem that none of us would have even thought became this much of a problem. So as she's going off, now Rachel starts going back at her like, what you complaining for? What you mad at? Like, the fuck is the problem? She's like, you keep bringing this bitch to the room. That's inconsiderate. You could at least tell me. She's like, I don't have to tell you shit. This is my room too. Woo, child ZPT, okay? Now they start. This is like a screaming match. Like a screaming match that I've never seen. I kid you not, I felt like I was on oxygen. I felt like I was on Bad Girls Club. It was really bad, and then it started to get disrespectful. Niggas started calling each other out their names. Bitch this, hoe that, fuck you this, fuck you that. But the thing is with Rachel, she's a very, very, like, goofy person, and she's the type of person, like, you can't really stay mad at. She's the type of person where, like, she's always cracking jokes. She's a very funny person. But at the time, everybody was really, really upset. At this point, she's saying, fuck Haiti, fuck y'all Haitians. She's saying, fuck all y'all, because the whole suite gets involved. Now, at this point, I'm not about to let her talk to my friend like that at this point. I thought it was going to be a little disagreement. But it became like an hour. Shit, I think it was like a three-hour argument. I'm not even joking. This was a three-hour argument. It was like ridiculous. We were just all going back and forth with each other. So I started to try to defend her. Everybody else came out their room. They trying to defend her. It became like a whole thing. She's like, fuck all y'all out. Fuck all y'all up. I got time today. Who the fuck y'all think y'all is? Like, it was really bad. Like, Rachel's going in on us. And she's literally threatening us. She really is. But again, Rachel is the type of person where, like, you don't even take things seriously from her. And in this type of situation, like, I guess it was just, like, a lot of fucking emotion. But Squeaky comes and she takes it upon herself to try to defend Michelle. Now, I said I ain't like Squeaky. Michelle didn't really necessarily not like her, but she wasn't cool with her on that type of close level for her to be trying to defend her. Even though we were all trying to defend her, we all stayed in our lane and stayed in the common area, and we were just yelling at the room. We were standing in the doorway. Squeaky took it upon herself to go inside the room. Now, at that point, bitch, you're causing problems. So Squeaky goes into the room and she's like, oh, don't talk to her like that. Don't that, that, that. And we're just like, oh, you wildin'. You're literally trespassing, you know? That is her room. BT, nigga, is like, get the fuck out my room. Get the fuck out my room. Squeaky is not having it. Bitch, get out my room. 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 I am telling you, get the fuck out my room.
I do what I want. I do what I want.
So she goes and she mushes Squeaky in the face. Woo, child. She mushes her. And Squeaky go wild. Squeaky go crazy, okay? I thought she was going to get some bass in her motherfucking voice, okay? She's like, don't fucking touch me. Don't go with a fucking thing. Don't fucking touch me. At this point, we all just like, oh, nah, this shit wild. Like, this shit wild. Now, what's really ridiculous about this is we live legitimately across the hall from the RA. That bitch ain't knock on the door not once. Niggas could have been dying in there. I don't think you guys understand how loud it was. The only people who would know how bad this was would be the niggas that had me on Snapchat when I first started YouTube, when I was at like maybe 2,000 subscribers. Because I kid you not, I almost made a series out of these bitches. That's how entertaining it was. Like, the shit that would go on in there make no sense. We would have fights all the time over stupid shit. So that whole situation happens. Eventually, after the 3 hours pass, the whole situation calms down or whatever. And the next day, everything's back to normal. Like, we're talking to Rachel. Michelle's talking to Rachel. Like, it was just like one of those things where I feel like everybody was just on edge and annoyed, especially with the whole Malisha not cleaning her shit. And then we had, like, you know, a new roommate or whatever. I feel like it was just like a girl's thing. You know, like, how, you know how, like, sometimes we just be acting up for no reason. I really don't think it was that serious. What the fuck? Malisha out here getting escorted to class by security. What the fuck? I get an email. Better yet, all of us get an email. Talk about how we gotta go down to, like, housing services or whatever to talk about what happened last night. Because one of us said that we felt like we was in danger. You went to go run your mouth for what? What are you running your mouth for, bitch? This had nothing to do with you, bitch. We're all cool, bitch. Why are you getting escorted, bitch? Like, we were so confused. We was like, bruh, like, y'all can take this email. You get this email too. Like, we were all just sitting there like, bruh, like, what the fuck? Like, the fact that we actually got through all of this without our raise in our business was amazing. So now we got, like, legit the school in our business. Now, like, we got, like, fucking deans and shit emailing us. Talk about stuff. Oh, yeah, you need to talk about what happened last night. Like, bitch, like, what the fuck? This Squeaky bitch, okay, Squeaky went to go tell the school that she felt threatened and she felt like Rachel was gonna do something to her. And it's like, seriously, really, like, what the fuck? This got Rachel kicked out of the dorm. So now, boom, replacement number motherfucking two. This shit was so fucking annoying. I don't think you understand. Everybody was pissed. Everybody was mad. Because again, we are a unit and we move together. At this point, we got two niggas missing from the unit. And now we're gonna have two strangers fucking shit up. Malisha don't like to clean her dish and she don't like to clean the stove, but she love to cook food with no salt. Now we gonna have another bitch. What the fuck is gonna happen next? Now, for the rest of the semester, that room stayed empty. So Michelle had absolutely no roommate. Now, Malaysia didn't really cause that many problems after that, but there were little things such as like not cleaning the bathroom and things like that. So of course, it was always like little issues and a lot of tension in the door. Now, another reason I don't like Squeaky is because not only did she get Rachel kicked out of the dorm, which was ridiculously unnecessary and fucking extra, she also did not like to take showers, and this made the air in the motherfucking dorm ridiculously unbearable, okay? So, yeah, she didn't take showers. And I know you guys are like, how the fuck you don't know? How you know that? Well, I'm the type of person who was very smart with my college career. And if you guys are in college, you should definitely look into doing this too. I only took classes on 2, max 3 days a week. I would do Monday, Wednesday, Friday, or strictly Tuesday and Thursday. I would be in class all day. However, it was perfect. Literally, I would do 3-hour classes. I would do literally 4 classes a day, and this would be perfect because then I'd be able to work or just, you know, edit. Because at the time, I was very, very passionate about YouTube. Like, I mean, I'm still passionate about it, but like back then, like the drive and motivation I had for YouTube was insane. Like, I really was like, oh my god, let me get this work done so I can edit. Like, it was my thing. So I really, really used to be in the dorm. Okay. But since I had an office, there was times where I was always in the office when I was trying to escape this madness because the bitch smelled. Okay, this is the main reason. The bitch smelled. Now, let me just tell you this right now. The way that the suites were set up, it wasn't like a door in front of door thing. It was a line. No, I think it was A, B, C, D. I was in D. Squeaky was with Jasmine in A. Okay? There's no fucking reason I should smell your dumb ass at D. All the way on the other side of the motherfucking apartment. That's nasty. Now, we knew homegirl ain't take showers because, like I said, I only took classes about 2 times per week. So I'm there Monday. I think I did Tuesday and Thursday classes that semester. I'm not really sure. But I was literally in the dorm most of the time. Because even when I did do Tuesday and Thursday classes, they would be late. They started at like 12. So realistically, I would be in the dorm and we would see like, okay, did she wake up in the morning? Nope. Did she take a shower? Nope. Did she go to the cafe? Yup. Like, so she going to eat. She ain't showering. She ain't nothing. She ain't going to work out. So she ain't got no excuse for not showering. She not doing nothing. She was literally just laying in bed. I don't even remember the bitch going to class. Probably why her dumb ass ain't graduate. Okay. She never took a shower. Like, we would sit there. We'd be like, yo, is she going to take a shower? Is she going to take a shower? And we took shifts. Yes, we took shifts monitoring if this girl was going to take a shower because we wanted to understand. Before we said something to her, we were like, what the fuck? Because Jasmine was really complaining because she was like, yo, I always have to fucking open the windows, bro. Like, I always have to open the windows. And I never understood because, like, sometimes I would go over there because Jasmine ended up becoming my best friend after. There'd be times I'm just coming to see her just in her room just to chill. And I'm like, bitch, it's cold as fuck in here. Why you got the window open? And she's like,
it smells in here. It smells really, really bad. I don't know what to do. This bitch won't take a shower. It smells horrible. I'm stressed.
Like, she was really like, I can't. Like, I really fucking can't. And we're just sitting there like, okay. Like, it can't be that bad. And then over time, that's when we started seeing how bad it really was. So that's why we started monitoring her and be like, bro, like, this bitch really don't shower. All she does is fucking make Chef Boyardee and crack mac and cheese and, like, sleep. Like, she don't even fucking go to class. So it was just annoying. Like, she's thinking up the shit. She's not cleaning the microwave or whatever. And on that... And then on top of that, the bitch loved to run her mouth. While all of this shit is happening, she's talking a lot of shit on Snapchat. The funny thing is, she would delete us on Snapchat to talk her shit. None of us have her on Snapchat. She literally blocked all of us so she can talk her shit in peace. But not much peace, bitch, because we know the people you know and they told us. So she would be sitting there talking like, oh, these bitches this, these bitches that. Oh my God, I fucking hate these hoes. Like, she was talking real hot, spicy, caliente shit. And we're just like, you want to talk all this shit? But then when we're in the dorm, she's literally like, hi guys, hi, how is it, you bye? And we're just like, we saw what you wrote on Snapchat. Don't even try it.
Now, the real messed up part about this is I was literally the only one that expressed a deep dislike for the girl, okay? I was the only one that confronted her and told her straight up, I ain't like her. Everybody else didn't really like her because clearly she stink and she's fucking up the microwave, but they didn't hate the girl. They didn't like really had like a genuine issue with her. She was just very, very annoying. And if anything, Ariel and Ashley were the ones that were genuinely her friend. They were the ones that actually pretty much advocated for her to be in the dorm in the first place, because I believe Ashley dormed with her when we were freshmen. So they were literally friends with the girl. They were nice to the girl. They would hang out with her. None of us really cared to hang out with the girl like that. Jasmine was her roommate, and Jasmine didn't care to hang out with her like that. So it was really, really, really messed up when she took it upon herself to go and run her mouth about us on Snapchat while she had us blocked. So we started ignoring her. We were like, you know what? We're not going to pay attention to this hoe no more, because no, like at this point, she was dead to me, because the fuck, like, what are you blocking us to talk shit for? My thing is, I already expressed dislike for you in your face. Like, I told you straight up, I ain't like your ass. My thing is, be real about it. Be upfront. If you're going to pop your shit not incognito. Pop your shit in the open. You have to block me to talk shit. Like, that's mad pussy. But at least with me, I didn't really care that much for the simple fact that, like, I didn't like you. Of course, if niggas don't like each other, they're going to talk shit. So that wasn't even the problem. It was the fact that she went real pussy about it, and she was talking shit about everybody else that was actually her friend. That's fake. So after that, we all got upset, of course, reasonably, and we just started ignoring her. Like, niggas just was not talking to her. We pretty much isolated the girl. She took it upon herself to take stickies out, like literally take stickies out and write disrespectful shit on all our doors and all our cabinets and stuff, and just all around the dorm trying to be funny. Like, oh, bitch, clean this. Oh, bitch, you eat too much of that. Like, I don't remember exactly what she wrote on all of this stuff, especially mine. I don't remember. But the thing is, I don't like you. This shit not funny. The fact of the matter is, I already said I don't like you. The fact that you're trying to be funny with me ain't funny. It ain't funny for me. It ain't funny for you. Because at that point, when I curse you out, when I say something to you, now I'm gonna look like a bad person. And that's exactly what happened. I cursed her the fuck out. And she wanted to go cry and do all of this extra shit. And it's like, bitch, I don't got time for that. Like, stop fucking playing with me. I'm not fucking playing with you, bro. Niggas really called her out on her shit. And since she wanted to put stickies on her shit, we put ketchup on her door. We put a whole bunch of other food items on her door because she thought shit was funny, right? So now we think that's funny. Of course, she was very, very upset by this. She cried some more, complained some more, but she was still all up in our face telling us all her business that may not have even been true now that I think about it. And, oh, child, stressful.
I never thought I could see a two-faced person in action like this. Like, she was the most two-faced person I've ever done encountered in my entire life. Like, she really would sit there and talk shit on Snapchat 2 hours ago, but then hit us up like, hey, guys! And we're just like, sitting on the couch like, bitch, bye. This girl was just ridiculously annoying, and even though she was talking shit about us, we just let her talk and we just ignored her, and she would just talk about shit that just made no sense. At one point, she was talking about how she literally got pregnant from giving head. It's not possible. If you thought it was possible, it's not. I would assume that anyone with common sense would know that it's not possible. She's also one of those girls that like to pride herself on being a virgin and like kind of like downplayed everyone that wasn't a virgin and try to make it seem like she was better than everyone because she was a virgin, but her mouth wasn't a virgin. So she would sit there and like give head to all of these niggas, but then come back and be like, oh, well, I'm a virgin, I'm a this, I'm a that. And it's like, I hate bitches like that. It's really annoying. Her not cleaning, her not taking the showers, her sitting there trying to downplay people that have lost their virginity and then like trying to act like she's holier than now because she's never lost hers. Like, it was just really, really annoying, to be quite honest with you. It was one of those situations where I was like, bitch, shut the fuck up. Like, I just did, I could not. Now we have the whole other situation with legit squad, okay? So like I said, we literally made sure we lived amongst each other because we felt like if we lived amongst each other, things would definitely be better, but this is not the case. So we had Ariel and Ashley who roomed together, and they were the ones that started acting the shadiest of the shadiest, and it was annoying. Now, to be quite frank with you, I was really closer to Ashley and not Ariel. Ariel was closer to Michelle. Me, Michelle, Ariel, and Ashley used to hang out more than anyone else, to be quite honest with you. Along with another girl we're going to call Katie. She used to be the closest knit, mainly because me, Ariel, and Michelle lived on the same floor freshman year. And then Ashley and Katie lived in the same dorm on the same floor. We just used to come together. But overall, Michelle had a more close-knit relationship with all of them. I was very to myself. I'm still really to myself. I got time for all of that. But nonetheless, Katie actually got excommunicated from the group because, you know what? That's a short story that I'm about to tell y'all right now because it's fucking hilarious. So Katie actually has a disease called sickle cell, and she was sick, and she told none of us that she was sick. She just fucking disappeared off the face of the earth. Like, we didn't know what happened to her. She wasn't answering text messages. We didn't see her on campus, but we didn't, like, we just thought that maybe we just haven't, I don't know, we didn't think anything of it. So whatever, long story short, I end up having a turn up. Now the thing is, me and Michelle, like I said, we're always roommates, and we would always have turn ups. Like, always. We used to be lit. Like every Thursday, because if you guys don't know, college turn up day is Thursday. Thursday is what's up. We would have a turn up, and everybody knew where the turn up was. Like if you knew where we live, you knew you was invited. We wouldn't sit there like, oh, turn up 8 o'clock, bring a bottle. Like we didn't do that. We would just be like, it's Thursday, lit. Like the funny thing is, I don't think there's any Thursday we ever skip. And like I said, it was common knowledge, especially amongst squad, when like if we were we were having things, because that's how much we had shit every single Thursday religiously. So Katie takes it upon herself to show up at one of these turnups like,
oh, y'all didn't invite me.
One, we didn't see you. Two, we found out you were sick, so we wanted to give you some space. And three, the fact that you had sickle cell and you're literally practically on your deathbed, because she was like literally sick, like in the hospital type shit, and you wanted us to invite you, makes no fucking sense. Bitch, you're sick. You trying to come drink Hennessy in fucking New Amsterdam with us? Like, I don't understand. We're not about to invite you when you're sick. And then on top of that, we're not about to invite you because we didn't invite nobody. Everybody just knows where to come. What the fuck are you talking about? So she basically saw it as, oh, well, we weren't checking up on her and we're bad friends. And honestly, I get where she's coming from with that. Like, if you have friends that really don't check in on you, that's really some fucked up shit. Like, on some real shit. Like, your friends should really check up on you. And I definitely understand where she was coming from with that. But honestly, her anger was misguided. And essentially, sophomore year, she cut us off completely. She started hanging out with different people. It was just really, really ridiculous because it's like, that really wasn't the intent. That really wasn't the problem. And all of this could have been definitely solved with a simple conversation, but instead she wanted to barge through my door and act up like I let me not say that but she wanted to barge through the door and act up like shit didn't stink. Like, bitch, you was fucking sick. We're not about to invite no bitch that's sick to our shit, and we're not about to invite anyone that comes. And yes, we should have checked in on you, but you don't communicate. I didn't even know the girl had sickle cell. I don't think most of us knew. I feel like half of us didn't even know she was sick. So it's like, how the fuck you blaming us? Like, I kid y'all not, if you guys are planning on going to college, but I'm telling you this right now, don't take most of these friendships seriously, because bitches be fucking playing. As much as I have some of the same friends from college and I love them to death and I still talk to them, some of these motherfuckers were just ridiculously out of pocket and out of line. And the bitch is lucky she didn't find 15-year-old me, because I would have knocked her head off. Because the way she came up in my dorm was just fucking ridiculous. Sadly though, I really do miss the friendship, and I really did love the girl. Like, wholeheartedly, she was definitely my favorite out of the bunch. It was just ridiculous. Insane how she came at us, and I was really, really upset by that. But nonetheless, whatever. So it used to be me, Michelle, Ariel, and Ashley after that. But like I said, Michelle was closer to them than I was. And we would mainly turn up when it was like, and when no one else wanted to come up, it would always be us core four hanging out and chilling, especially with the boys. The boys have nothing to do with this, so I don't have to give them names or really add them into this until a little bit later, because there's another reason I don't like squeaking. The thing is, with the whole turn up situation, we would do this thing where we would all put money in for bottles. We'd all put 5, 10, whatever much it is, and, you know, go to the liquor store. One of us would go to the liquor store and buy the bottles, because, as you know, you have to be 21 to buy liquor. A lot of us weren't 21, or we would give it to another one of our friends who was over the age of 21 to buy liquor for us. Usually, we would do it, like, Wednesday or Thursday morning. We'd be like, oh, we turning up tomorrow. What we drinking? Da-da-da. And we'd be like, all right, who's putting in for the bottle? And then, you know, everybody would be like, oh, I got 5. Well, I got 10. Well, I got 3. Well, whatever. And, you know, whoever it was would assemble the money. Was there Cash App at the time? I think there was. I feel like there was Cash App at the time. I feel like Cash App had just came out. So we would get Cash App or cash, whatever it was. And whoever it was would go to the liquor store and get the liquor, and all would be well. So what these niggas would do, okay, Ashley and Ariel would do this thing where they'd be like, okay, what y'all want to drink? And we would be like, okay, what y'all getting? Because I would assume that if we all want the same thing, it would be easier to just get all the same thing. So me and Michelle told them, like, oh, let's get this. And we just wanted Thotties, because, I mean, I think it was like a chill night. I feel like it was like midterms or something like that. It was something going on, but me and her just wanted Thotties. And they were like, oh, okay, we're going to get some Thotties too. Thotties are like margaritas, Four Loko, stuff like that. Those are Thotties. They bought the Thotties. They gave us our Thotties. And they went right into their room, and we're like, me and Michelle are sitting there like, so we not gonna drink this together? Like, why they just go in their room like that? Weird as hell. All of a sudden, we see the boys going into their room. Now, like I said, there's boy squad, there's girl squad, but all together we make a squad. Now, the thing is with this, which was weird, is that the boys are me and Michelle's friends. Not to say that they're not their friends, because like I said, we all a big squad, but like, y'all met the boys because of us. So you invited our friends to hang out with y'all without us. And we were like, okay, that's strange. So me and Michelle started to observe. So we sat in the living room area, and we're like, what the fuck is going on here? Like, so we see the boys coming in. And it wasn't all of them. Those was just like a select few. And we see they got legit bottles. Okay, we see Hennessy. We see New Amsterdam. We see Pomasson. We see A&J. We're just like, y'all bought us 30s, but went to go buy yourselves legitimate liquor. Make that fucking make sense. Why didn't y'all tell us y'all was really trying to turn up then? Like, we didn't understand what the, like, why. Like, it was just mad shady, because it's like, why did y'all go and get yourselves this and then run in y'all rooms trying to hide it and then invite our friends to hang out with y'all? It was fucking weird. We were like, what the hell? And like, at first I was like, maybe I'm just thinking too deep into shit, but it was Michelle that pointed it out to me. And then we literally were like, okay, you know what, maybe it's just us. So we did this consecutively, you know, over the weeks. We're like, oh, we want this, da da da, like, you know, we were asking for different things, and they would continuously just bring us back like thotties or some like low liquor nonsense, and then they would sit there and like do their own thing with their liquor for real, for real. And we're just like, that's shady. And it's weird because like, we used to turn up together, like all together as a unit, all 12, 14, however much of us there was. Okay, like it used to be all of us. So it's just like, it was very, very strange. And then it started to make shit real awkward for the boys, because they're like, oh, we don't know who to hang out with. We hanging out with Michelle and Shorty, or we hanging out with Ariel and Ashley. Because even though our rooms are like in the same suite, like niggas would stay there or they would stay here. It was just really fucking wild to me. Like, oh my God, like this shit really fucked us up. And you guys would be like, okay, well, it's just liquor. It's not that serious. Honestly, to a college student, it is that serious. Not only that, it's just the principle and the morals of it. Like, we're supposed to be friends. We always hang out. We always drink together. We turn up together. So it's just a little weird that you buy us this, but then you're turning up and hiding what you have with our friends. It's fucking weird. So at that point, tension started to mount between us, like me, Michelle, Ariel, and Ashley. But again, Michelle was still more with them. I was more like on some, I really don't give a fuck for these bitches no more, because once I see some shit, once I peep some shit, I'm gone, I'm done. And I had more things to worry about anyway. Now, I'm gonna just tell you this right now, and honestly, like I said, people are gonna be very upset by this video, most likely. Michelle was actually pregnant, and what annoyed me is all of this turning up or whatever we were doing, she didn't tell anyone that she was pregnant. So we spent the entire semester turning up, going to parties, all of this extra shit, and she didn't tell anyone. The only people that knew was me and Jasmine. So second semester comes, or is coming, I should say, we're about to leave for Christmas break. This is when she kind of like divulges information about her baby father and all of this nonsense. And honestly, I would say that the friendship with her kind of got a little strained. And honestly, we're still best friends, I guess, to an extent. But this shit has always bothered me and never sat right with me. And she knows this, that she was literally smoking and drinking while she was pregnant and didn't say nothing to me or Jasmine or anyone else of the sort until it was too late. So as you guys can imagine, my boyfriend's fucking deployed, my best friend smoking and drinking while she's pregnant, my roommates are fucking batshit crazy, I'm living with a stinky bitch that don't like to clean the microwave, I'm living with another bitch that don't like to clean the stove or clean her dishes, bitches is always fighting over shit that don't even make sense. I was extremely stressed and annoyed. I believe I failed a class that year as well. Like, shit was just fucking annoying. So now second semester rolls around and my roommate Malicia decides to leave. I don't know what happened to her, to be quite honest with you. She just disappeared, but whatever. Now I get a new roommate, and so does Michelle. And we're gonna name her Grandma, because she used to dress like a grandma. She had this ass and she used to talk like this, and she used to have her sweater, and she used to like, she had, you know how like people had that cardigan, she used to like, and she would just talk like this, like, she was so fucking annoying, so we just gonna call her Grandma. And Grandma ended up beefing with Michelle. Shit ended up going really bad. Mainly because she was just inconsiderate, leaving the light on, just being rude, coming in all times of the day or night or whatever. Which you guys were probably like, oh, okay, well, she has the right. But again, like I said, Michelle is pregnant. And I really feel like a lot of this had to do with hormones. But long story short, shit ended up going on for weeks. To the point where Michelle and Grandma ended up having a legit argument. A legit almost fight, to the point where Grandma was like, I don't care how you feel,
We could fight because your face ain't pregnant.
We all looking at her like, first of all, bitch. Like, the funny thing is she was a freshman as well. And we were just like...
I actually got into an altercation with grandma because my boyfriend had sent me flowers from wherever, because you know you could send flowers to anyone no matter where you are. And I'm very weird. I actually don't like flowers really, but I like the gesture of it. I like to show them off or whatever, but I like the smell of dead flowers. People might find this weird, but I really do. I love the smell of dying flowers. Like, it's so weird. I don't know. I don't like the way they look, but I like the way they smell. And basically, grandma kept complaining that the smell of the flowers was bothering her nose when we weren't even in the same room. Like, yeah, she was in the room next to me, but bitch, what are you talking about? So she kept trying to get me to like throw out my flowers and stuff. And the thing is with me, since I kind of have like an attachment issue low key, I don't like to really throw out any gifts that people give to me, even if it's a flower. That's why I really don't like to get flowers, because they die and it makes me really, really sad. Like, I get really, really emotional over dying flowers, even though I like the smell of them. It's kind of like a thing where it's like, I like the flowers, but I know they're going to die and it makes me sad, but I like the smell of them. Very weird. So she's like literally throwing shade and just talking shit. And like, she's sitting in the common area like, oh my God, get rid of them flowers, shorty, get rid of them flowers, shorty. And the thing is, my room was directly in front of the common area. So it's like, bitch, why don't you go sit in your fucking room or sit on the other side in the kitchen so it doesn't bother your nose, you fucking bitch. So I was fed up with her. Michelle was fed up with her. She was kind of annoying, but I think me and Michelle were the ones that mainly had an issue with her.
Now, of course, Michelle was an avid. She was trying to fight with a baby in her belly and everything. Shit ended up going real, real left, real, real quick. And that, I believe, is how Michelle ended up having to be moved to another suite, where her situation actually was worse there. She should have stayed where she was at. But nonetheless, that was a whole nother problem within itself. So I believe that's when the two best friends came, Kasia and Milan or whatever. And you know, Milan was definitely with grandma and I was with Kasia. Like I said, I actually really, really liked them. I didn't have any problems with them. Like I said, I personally didn't have much problems with anyone but Squeaky, to be honest. Squeaky and then Ashley and Ariel, because yeah, Kasia and Milani, they were freshmen. Kasia was my roommate. Milani was Michelle's roommate. And shit was pretty cool. They were really, really nice. They were freshmen. But Kasia really pissed me off right off the bat, because she liked to have friends over at all times of the motherfucking night. And they were fucking loud and they were fucking ghetto. So literally, I'm trying to hang out in my room. I'm trying to edit. I'm trying to do this, that, and the third. And she had all these motherfuckers in the room. And it was fucking annoying, to the point where at one point, when I first met her, literally, like, you can imagine this is like a horrible first impression. You find out you have a new room. You go into the new roommate, you know, to go meet the new roommate, and they have like six bitches in the room, and it's like 11 o'clock at night, and you gotta sleep, you gotta study, you gotta edit. So right off the bat, I was really, really annoyed. Luckily, things fixed itself, definitely fixed itself after the fact, but it was just really, really fucking annoying. It was like, what the fuck, like, oh my God. So Ashley and Ariel ended up moving out the suite as well, and we got two more roommates after that, and we're going to name them the twins, because separately, they didn't really do much. And it's funny because I actually still really fuck with one of the twins. Every time I see her, like, it's great. Like, I love her. I see her, like, sometimes onto the Blue Moon every time I go to, like, YouTube events and stuff like that, because she does makeup. So, like, I really love her. But I'm going to have to let you guys know this right now. I might have to do the story time over. If I can find the story time, I'll link it, but I don't know. She was friends with our alleged stalker. So you can imagine when we saw the twins... Okay, both of these twins were friends with our alleged stalker. When we saw the twins, we were like, you have to be fucking kidding me. I had two different roommates, essentially. Okay, two different roommates. Technically three, if we count the one that never showed up, okay? Danielle never showed up. So technically, we had two replacements for me. We have whole new people coming in because Ariel left along with Ashley. Now we have Milani, which is with Michelle, because Rachel... done left, and she had an empty room. So now we got four new people in the suite. We're like, bruh, half the fucking suite is a replacement. So me, Michelle, Jasmine, and even Squeaky are just like, yo, what the fuck? We're like, what the fuck? Like, this shit is fucking incredible. Our stalkers are moving into the suite. This has to be a joke. Our stalkers are moving into the suite. Now, just a quick little synopsis on, if you guys never seen that story, which I'm sure a lot of you guys have not. Literally, our stalkers broke into me and Michelle's dorm and stole our laptops along with money. Therefore, seeing the friends of our alleged stalkers in our dorm literally gave everybody a fucking panic attack. They were harassing all of us through text message, literally cutting bitches' weaves, putting cum in their hair. Listen, very wild story. I might have to redo it if it's not on the channel. I might just redo it regardless because this story is fucking insane. So we were on edge like, what the fuck? And what's very interesting is right after they moved in, all of a sudden we started getting text messages again. Which is crazy because, like, we didn't get one for, like, that entire year until they moved in. Luckily, we ignored it and it went away anyway, but it was just ridiculous. The person that we definitely thought was our stalker ended up moving or leaving schools or whatever. She ended up being pregnant or whatever anyway. Like, it was just a whole fucking synopsis of bullshit.
What's really interesting about this stalker thing, especially with the stealing and all of that, is somehow, magically, one of my purses ended up going missing while I was on campus. And it literally got stolen like right out of my room. And that shit pissed me off so badly because my roommate, Keisha, at the time loved to leave the motherfucking door open because she always lost her keys or whatever. And as a result, my shit ended up getting stolen. And I never, to this day, I don't know what happened to that bag. Woo, child, I was on edge. Y'all, I was so fucking upset because someone literally stole my shit out of my room. The first stalker was freshman year and it was our freshman dorm that the person broke into and stole our shit, but it was like deja vu. I was fucking stressed. I brought all my very valuable shit right back home because I was like, I'm not dealing with y'all hoes, bruh. I'm really not.
So nonetheless, we still tried to make the best of what we had and we would try to have turn-ups with the boys or whatever, try to like just be together because it ended up becoming like a serious, like, what the fuck? Like, it was a point where no one in the suite was talking. We wasn't saying good morning. We wasn't hanging out. Nobody was sitting in the common area. Everybody just stuck in their room. It was that bad. It got to a point where we would have the boys over and I would keep them in the D suite, which was my room, because like we didn't really want them in the common area because Squeaky was like a fucking low-key sexual predator. Like, kid you not, every time the boys was over, she want to put on her booty shorts. She want to come be loud as she can be with her squeaky-ass voice. She want to come make a scene. Like, she's just trying to show out. You know how, like, there'd be girls that just want attention. They father or they mother and give them enough attention. So now they're just, like, trying to show out and try to... That's what she was doing. And it was just, like, so fucking annoying. The boys was not interested. She's not cute. We were there to turn up. We was there to chill. And the funny thing is, I actually have some of the vlogs up on my channel, which is hilarious. I have some of them. I feel like some of them are private, but I do have some vlogs up on my channel that definitely highlight a lot of the turning up that we used to do. Like, our turn-ups used to be real, real wild, real, real lit, real, real crazy. And we would turn up, have all of these situations. And she would just be killing the vibe, like, trying to, like, sit on the niggas' laps. Trying to do this, then a third. And eventually it got to a point where she allegedly gave one of the boys in squad a head in the bathroom. Basically, grandma was saying she saw it and woo child, this became an altercation for fucking weeks. So at this point, grandma is calling her a hoe. Okay, she's calling Squeaky a hoe. Squeaky saying she not a hoe, she not this, she not that. She's never lost her virginity. Kid you not, this was like a fucking argument every night. It was a problem every night and we're just like, bruh. Like, why can't we just turn up with the boys? Like, why can't we, like, my thing is, I can't stand a bitch that can't hang, bro. Like, we trying to chill with the niggas. We trying to chill with our friends at the end of the day. It's not even, like, one of those things. It's never been a sexual thing or anything like that. Like, we're friends at the end of the day. Like, we're cool. We're homies. We love each other. We should be able to have friends. We should be able to be cool. Yeah, it became a situation where, like, we were, like, we didn't want to have the boys over because it was, like, they were literally being sexually harassed. I'm not even fucking joking. It was, like, a whole situation. Shit was fucking ridiculous. So, at one point, everything really, really, really exploded, okay? So, just to give a little quick preface, she's still not taking showers. She's still not cleaning the motherfucking microwave. She's still annoying me. She's getting into altercations with grandma. Michelle already don't like her. The new girls don't hate her, per se. But they're kind of annoyed because, again, they can also smell her from across the suite. Like, so, again... Lots of tension. All of it is petty.
What's really funny is Jasmine was her roommate. And Jasmine is a very quiet person. Like, she doesn't really raise her voice. She doesn't go off on people whatsoever. And it got to a point where she was trying to study because she was a biochem major. And Squeaky just kept coming in and out of the room without closing the door. But she had the TV out in the common area super loud. And basically, Jasmine was like, yo, if you're going to do all of this, right? Like, if you're going to keep going in and out, please, for the life of me, like, just close the door. Like, because she, you know, biochem is very difficult. Like, if you are a biochem major, comment down below, you know what I'm talking about. Like, it's very difficult. You have to retain a lot of information, and you can't be having people doing stupid shit. So she was straight up, she was like, yo, like, on some real shit, like, please, like, just close the door. And she wouldn't close the door. So, woo child, Jasmine got up and she started screaming at her. And I was the only one in the suite. I remember it was me, her, and Squeaky. And, like, everybody else was, like, in class or out and about. And all I hear is, like, all this commotion. Oh, my God. Jasmine started screaming at her. She was going in. She was like, you stupid bitch. You don't fucking close the door. I told you to close the fucking door. I'm like, oh, what is going on? Like, yo, bruh, when you got the person that don't even be yelling and don't even causing no problems, mad, it's a fucking problem.
So eventually it comes to a point where we decided to have an intervention. All of us sat around in a circle and we talked and we addressed all our issues with one another and everything seemed to be fine. Everything was great. Like, everybody was like, oh yeah, like, you know, I love you. Everything was great. Y'all. All of a sudden, Squeaky goes, yeah, you know, I'm happy everything is settled and all, but I still don't understand why Grandma got an attitude and she don't like me. Everything was peaceful until you done ran your motherfucking mouth. Now, Grandma starts fighting back. Now, the thing is, Grandma had a real spicy tongue. She's like, bitch, because I don't like you, bitch.
It was a hot-ass bitch. Out here sucking dick in the bathroom, bitch.
Y'all, I'm just sitting there like, I was on the couch literally like this the whole time. Like, this is not about to happen right now. They start going at it full force, like screaming at each other. With all the altercations we've had in this dorm, kid you not, the RA has never came, not once. And I believe this was because she was pledging girls. If you guys know, the pledging process usually happens at night. And usually the people that are pledging, whoever, the people who are pledging are really, really tired. So maybe she just didn't want to deal with us. I don't fucking know. I have no idea. Maybe the doors were soundproof. I highly doubt it because we were loud. They start having a full-blown screaming match.
Bitch, fuck you. You a hoe. You a thot. You a bitch. You a that.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. Let me be a hoe. I'm a hoe that sucks dick. Yeah, and I suck that dick too. And I suck this dick. Ew, what? Yeah, you right. I suck dick. She's just running through the dorm like, I suck dick. And we're just like, the girl just needed a fucking, like, hug or something. She needed a mom, a dad, or something. Like, the bitch was so fucking extra. She was always doing the most. It was so fucking annoying because it's like, why are you like this? Just shit your ugly ass the fuck down, you damn peacock. Like, she was just so fucking annoying, yo. Like, they're going back and forth. Like, they're going at it. I definitely know I had on my Snapchat. I would probably actually fuck around and download Snapchat just to get that video if that shit would be saved. I highly doubt it'd be saved because Snapchat's delete. But y'all, this shit was incredible. Like, they were going at it. She's calling herself a hoe. She's saying she's a dick. Then you got fucking Grandma, like, yep, you's a hoe, I'm glad you know. Like, it was just so inappropriate and ridiculous, and at this point, niggas was real, real tired. What's
really funny about this is the reason that Squeaky was out here, like, literally trying to be like, yeah, and I sucked him off, now what, is because I feel like there was some type of, like, unspoken type of beef between them trying to get with one of the boys in squad, to the point where, like, I feel like they kind of, like, thought that they were in some sort of competition to get him, and it's like, he don't want either one of y'all. Like, it was just embarrassing. These girls are so embarrassing. The fact that, like, your way of competing with a girl is, yeah, and I sucked him off. Oh, these bitches goofy.
Fast forward, yeah, Michelle has her baby. Everything is fine. I feel like everyone moved out perfectly fine. I feel like eventually everyone became pretty amicable. Everything became really, really cool. But at the end of the day, this really fucked up our friendship because although Ariel and Ashley ended up commuting and they were no longer in the dorm, we barely saw them and we barely talked to them. I stopped talking to Danielle because she actually let me do the fucking Labor Day parade by myself, which really pissed me the fuck off. Yeah, long story short, she tried to act like she wanted to be down, but then didn't pay for her costume last minute, so I ended up doing it alone. Playing mob by yourself is fucking annoying. Being in the Labor Day parade by yourself is really dangerous and very boring. I mean, I had fun nonetheless, but it was like, whatever. So I stopped talking to her because of that.
And the boys ended up pledging for the most part. I feel like every boy in my squad is Greek with the exception of one. And yeah, like all of us kind of grew apart. So if you guys saw the vlog that I made, one of the recent vlogs that I made, we actually ended up coming together for the first time since junior year of college. Senior year, everyone really disbanded. I actually ended up rooming with Jasmine, and like that was it. Michelle was commuting, Ariel was commuting, Ashley ended up transferring or dropping out of school, Danielle was at her respective school, Rachel graduated with us as well. But like it was one of those situations where it's like we all grew apart really badly. Luckily, me and Michelle were still really close with the boys, as well as Jasmine. So it was literally the three of us that were really close with the boys, and we still maintained a good relationship with everyone, hence why they were mainly the ones that were at the thing. Ariel was the one that I really didn't fuck with after all of this, but we actually ended up rekindling, and she was supposed to be at the thing that I had, but she couldn't due to work, sleep, whatever, something like that. So yeah, realistically, there's four girls left in squad, like six boys. We got a couple people that's been excommunicated, but whatever, it is what it is. The moral of the story is do not live with your friends, because at the end of the day, you guys get along, but when you start living with people, when you start actually seeing them on a day-to-day, like wake up, sleep type shit, it ends up being different. You start seeing their true colors, you start seeing how dirty they are, you start seeing how annoying they are, you start seeing how messy they are, and it's just not a good thing for your overall friendship. So if you care about your friends, literally, you'd be better off rooming with strangers. I'm telling you this right now. Even though I've heard some really horrible stories with like stranger roommates, I would rather ruin my relationship with someone I don't know than ruin my relationships with people I do know. So for anyone who made it to this point in the story, comment down below, what is your roommate's experience? But if you don't have one, comment down a star. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for making it to the end of this video. Definitely got another Storytime movie coming up for you guys. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I will see y'all next time.